Welcome to LaBandeja.com. Once again, we're here with Andrew Seya. Welcome to La Bandeja.
Thank you for the opportunity.
So tell us, it's been a month since we last spoke to you. What has been going on? What's new?
We registered about 500 new voters. We've knocked on 7,000 doors. And we are very enthusiastic about the response that we received. The type of campaign that we're running transcends race, religion, ethnicity. We're breaking down barriers and we're building bridges.
So you're feeling confident so far?
I am cautiously optimistic that we will be victorious on May 11th. So my confidence is at an all-time high. And you have to peak at this time. You have to reach your peak. And I feel like we're going to peak at the right time.
So Andrew, I'm sure you're aware, there have been some rumors going on, and with only 2 weeks till Election Day, we want you to clarify it.
Sure.
The first thing we heard was that you first started for Board of Education, if people don't know, and then you were a councilman, right?
Yes.
People want to know, why did you stop from Board of Education to councilman? What happened?
All right. Let's set the record straight. In 2002, I was appointed to the Board of Education. And then in 2004, I won a seat. I was elected to the Board of Education. Then I was reelected in 2007, so I actually had two terms on the Board of Education. I didn't abandon the Board of Education. I was elected in 2008 to the City Council, and I saw how city government was not working. And I felt, with my background, my work experience, and my educational experience, that I can do better than what the current mayor is doing. And that's what propelled me to decide to run for mayor.
Okay, so you stopped Board of Education because you thought you had done everything you wanted to do for the education of Patterson?
Yes, because we're a state-operated district, and we're somewhat restricted in what we can do. So I felt like the next step was to try to learn more about city government so that somehow I can influence not only how the city works, but also how the schools work as well. And then hopefully we can receive local control back, because the state has been operating our school district for about 18 years.
What did you accomplish in Board of Education?
Yes, I'm glad you asked that question. School uniforms was very big. For me, it was an issue that I pursued rigorously and vigorously. And some schools have them, not all do, because you can't mandate it. Also, the curriculum, we didn't have an aligned curriculum with the students are learning. And it was the first time in a long time that we had a standard curriculum for the students, so that every student in every school was learning the same thing. And also, the Board of Education building was downtown, and we were in bad leases. We were all over. We were on Church Street, Grand Street, Ellison Street, and I made that push to move it to one location to save money on all these leases, and they moved to the 6th Ward, my ward, 90 Delaware Avenue, and I was influential and instrumental in working with the superintendent and my school board colleagues in making that a reality. Of course, and as mayor, I'll work with the superintendent and my former colleagues on the Board of Education. See, one advantage I have, of all the candidates that are running for mayor, I'm the only one that served on the Board of Education and served on the City Council. Not to mention, I've served on every level of government. Federal government, I worked for Congressman Bill Pascrell for 4 years. State government, I worked for Senator John A. Girgenti as his chief of staff for 3 years. And then locally, I've been on the Board of Education and on the City Council. So I have the qualifications and I have the commitment.
What about for councilman? What did you accomplish and what did you stop?
Okay. Quality of life is the highest priority, receives the highest priority with me. Go-go bars. There were some illegal go-go bars. There was Charlie's Angels on Robert Street in South Patterson. It was situated in a residential area. And the people complained to me, and as a councilman who took an oath of office, I felt like it was my obligation to assist them. And we rallied those residents, and we closed Charlie's Angels down. Shortly thereafter, Alex's Playground on 21st Avenue, a man was murdered inside after hours. Therefore, it doesn't look like the ordinances have been enforced. So we did the same thing. We rallied the merchants, the residents. I got some of the clergy involved, and we closed down that go-go bar as well. I sponsored an ordinance to create a youth commission, which would say that young people can serve on an advisory board alongside adults, so they maybe can influence decisions that are made that affect them. So the youth commission would say, 10 young people selected by the 9 council members and the mayor would serve alongside 5 adults, and they would be making they would influence some decisions. Also, I promoted an abandoned properties ordinance. And an abandoned properties ordinance is a part of a state law to create a list of all the abandoned properties in Patterson so that we get a handle on them. Because if you have abandoned properties, it leaves itself open for crime. People can go to a vacant home or abandoned property. Drug deals take place, perhaps prostitution, whatever it may be. So if we don't have a list and we don't know where they are, how can you encourage investors to come and develop in the city? And so I advocated for that for over 2 years. In fact, at first, the mayor was opposed to this idea. Maybe it was because it wasn't his own. But we worked on it, and eventually we got him to see the light, and now it's part of the law in the city. So those are just some of the things that I've done.
Tell us a little bit more about your plans. A big problem here in Patterson is, of course, education.
Right.
It's one of the, it's ranked, I think, it's not the third? Not the fifth, yeah, the third one in New Jersey.
Yeah.
What do you plan on doing?
Well, I met with the superintendent. He's new, so he's a visionary. And I share that same vision, the community schools concept, where schools do not close after 3 o'clock because a public school is a public building. And they should remain open for after-school activities and anything over the weekend. It may cost some money, but we could shift money around and work with the Board of Education. I want to buy into that community schools concept because other cities have done it effectively.
So what are you going to do different that the previous mayor hasn't done to stop prostitution, gangs, and all that?
I'm going to be 3 things. Accessible, approachable, and accountable. Accessible, people will know where to find me. For example, a couple years back, there were protesters outside of City Hall, taxpayers, who had seen an increase as a result of the revaluation, and he never came out to meet with them. And that's all they wanted, just for him to assure them that somebody was on their side, especially the city's leader, that he was going to fight for them. I'm going to be accessible. If they're outside, I'm going to be with them, because I serve them. I represent them. They elected me. Even if they didn't vote for me, I still am their representative as far as the mayor is concerned. Approachable. Someone people can see on the street, tap them on the shoulder, say, I got to talk to you about a problem. Or, I think you're doing a good job. Maybe they pat me on the back, right? And then accountable. If things go right, I'll take the credit along with those who are also responsible. But if things go wrong, I got to accept some of the blame. We've got to assume the responsibility. That's how I'm going to be different. It's a leadership style. It's about management. Treating people with respect.
There have been some rumors going around that you won't understand the Latino community because, of course, you're not Hispanic. But how do you feel about this?
Well, one thing people have to understand is they take a look at my team. I have Colombians, I have Peruvians, I have Dominicans, I have Ecuadorians, Puerto Ricans, and they have influence in decisions that I make. And in my administration, they will continue to have influence in decisions I make. I've walked every ward. I've done my best to learn Spanish. Necesito aprender más y practicar más. But you don't have to be a certain ethnicity to understand people. You just have to respect and admire and appreciate, I should say, the people that you serve.
To finish the interview,
First
we'd like to thank you for your time.
Thank you.
What would you like to tell the people with only 2 weeks till the elections?
Okay. Well, the Peruvian American Political Action Committee saw fit to endorse me, and I thought that was a major endorsement because they had endorsed the mayor in the years prior. And people from all different walks of life are gravitating towards us. We feel a lot of momentum. In fact, there may be some other endorsements coming down the line. Stay tuned. And we're coming down to the home stretch. And we're going to finish with a flourish. Because we've knocked on so many doors. Like I said, 7,000 doors. I've gone through 6 pairs of shoes. I'm keeping like Marshalls in business. That's where I get them. But I do want to tell people that on May 11th, there's some folks that will be surprised. I will not be surprised. People on my team will not be surprised. Because we know that we've put in the work. We've done what we're supposed to do. We had a strategy and we executed. We're here at my headquarters. It's also the war room. And you could look around. And you'll see the goals that we set and that we have high expectations for our campaign. But we have to maintain that momentum going in after our victory on May 11th because I believe Patterson's been set behind. We need to be a 21st century city. We have to leverage technology. We have to make sure that if there are practices that are taking place in other places, they become a part of our practices here. We got to take this city to the next level. And it starts by changing leadership. And that's why I'm asking on May 11th for people to give change a chance for a new day. But before we can do any of that, we have to be united. Regardless of whether or not you're a Latino, you're an Arab, you're Italian, you're African American, whatever it may be, you're a Pattersonian. May 11th, let's stand united for a new day.
Thank you.